So real-time analytics, again, the real-time analytics can be broadly divided into two different segments. And the first one is what you call as a real-time streaming. And in streaming, what you do is you do the analytics immediately after the data is produced. So the moment the data is produced, it goes through some kind of a real-time pipeline, and it's constantly spitting out analytics. And one of the characteristics of streaming is the analytics is running continuously on and on for days and months, keeps on running. The second broad real-time analytics is what we call as interactive. And so in this case, what happens is like the analytics is, the data, whenever it arrives, is stored in some kind of a persistent storage, either it might be in the disks or flash or whatever might be the case. And whenever you like to do some kind of analytics on top of this data, you kind of come up with a query or write your job, whatever it is. Then moment you fire the job, and it should return in with a few seconds or even a milliseconds. So the whole idea is like you are exploring the data, then you discover something, then immediately you wanted to drill down further into that, so that it's kind of gives you a more of an interactive session. And in order to be interactive, you don't want to be like, I type a query, go and have a coffee and chat with my friends and come back and the analytics is ready, because that cycle is too long. So in the matter of few seconds and milliseconds, if it comes back, then you're more productive. So the focus of the whole Udacity course is with respect to streaming, because the Storm is essentially a tool to get your streaming analytics done as quickly as possible. That is a broader. So now what is real time? I mean, in different domains and different markets and different enterprises, real time means different things for different people. So loosely, like we define real time in certain ways, but before we get to what exactly it is, let us see the spectrum of what are the various type of what you call the time duration. So the first is what we call is OLTP systems. So OLTP systems tend to have a kind of a 500 millisecond budget, and that is probably the fastest kind of analytics that you can think of. And it is very latency sensitive, in the sense like whenever, let us say you go to the ATM and say I'm withdrawing some money, and immediately the account has to be updated. Similarly, like whenever a tweet is what you call posted by you, like then you might have a lot of followers, and those followers have to get the tweet right away within a budget of 500 milliseconds. So think about doing that kind of what you call fan out. That's what we call the term, a fan out for like 30 million users. For example, in the case of Obama having 30 or 33 or 35 million users, how do you replicate that tweet, whatever he does, to all its followers within the 500 milliseconds? So on the other end of the spectrum is like the batch analytics, which takes a lot of hours and days. And that is characterized by high throughput, because the reason why the batch takes a long amount of time is because of disk IOs, in the sense like you are munging through so much data. And if there's a lot of data, then the disk has this limitation of 100 megabits per second. You can't go more than that. So in order to overcome that limitation, you employ multiple disks so that you can get data simultaneously across each disk in parallel. So when you employ a lot of such disks and the data is much higher than that, it takes hours and days, and hence throughput is very important for these kind of batch analytics. And mostly the batch analytics is used for doing ad hoc queries. And in between the two, it's what we call loosely a real time. I mean, in the sense like it's like a few seconds. And one of the characteristics of the real time is what you call is approximation. So the real time need not be very exact. I mean, there could be requirements where it could be exact, but from a Storm definition point of view or from Twitter definition point of view, real time is more an approximation. So that it gives visibility into your business right away, or the activities that you are monitoring for real time analytics right away, and still it gives some kind of approximate idea. Downsides of the approximation is how close are you to the exact? So there should be some kind of bounds to the actual real value, right? So as long as the approximation is like 5 to 10% off from the actual values, then you're okay. So then what we also do at Twitter is like we do run a batch analytics, but that is comes a little bit like 4 or 5 hours later and fixes these approximations of real time as real time keeps forging ahead. So that is where we kind of what we call as more of a real time analytics is. Analytics is a few seconds. Now, why we do real time? Why should you care that why things should be in real time? And world is going real time, and of course, Twitter is synonymous with real time. And there's a bunch of examples. First is real time trends, because Twitter is known for breakout news stories or breakout any incidents, and that spreads like fire in real time. So we have to be on top of real-time trends. The second aspect is real-time conversations. As you are watching a sports game, and as if some either somebody scored or something that they did, and people wanted to instantly start a conversation, and Twitter is one of the places where people start a conversation, and millions of conversation keeps going at any given time. And third aspect is real-time recommendations. As these real-time trends and conversations are emerging, Twitter wants to take advantage of those by injecting the appropriate product recommendations during the time, so that people can do some kind of impulsive buying or even ad, so that you can click on those ads, which translates into bottom line for us. So then finally, like real-time search, where as new events and in real-time incidents and trends are happening, and you wanted to search it because in the context of Twitter, you will be getting those incidents with respect to whomever you are following. But the search.twitter.com allows you to search for all the tweets. So in other words, as these tweets are coming in, we have to continuously index them so that when you go to search.twitter.com, it's real time in the sense like all the tweets that happened in the last second or last few seconds is immediately available to you as a part of the results of the search. So we have a budget of less than 200 milliseconds in order to do that. So some kind of discussion. Louis, you want to facilitate some discussion about big data applications?
Sure. So this is just a question for the group. What are some of the examples of real-time systems that you have seen, real-time applications, and maybe ideas that you want to see?